hard hats and hammers, levels and ladders, construction has begun. Rivets and ratchets, gauges and gadgets, that's how we get it done. And concrete and cranes, we're building our faith on Christ, the cornerstone. The foundation's laid, the cross beams raised, our strength is in God alone. And concrete and cranes, and concrete and cranes, concrete and cranes, it's concrete and cranes.
Hey kids, welcome to day four of
concrete. Hey Connie, sorry I didn't mean to interrupt, but where'd you get that blowpipe?
Well, I got it for doing some good things.
Good construction things, I bet?
Yeah.
Can I have a blowpipe?
Well, after we say our motto and our verse, I promise I'll give you one at the end of the day.
Ooh, okay. So, I gotta say the motto, and I gotta say the voice. Can I practice?
Yeah.
Okay. The motto. I'll practice in a really quiet voice so you don't hear me.
Okay.
The motto is, Jesus, our firm foundation. I think I got that right. And the voice is, I am sure this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Philippians 1:6. I got this. So to get a blow pop, all I got to do is say the motto and the voice at the end of the day, and you give me a blow pop?
That's right.
You promise?
I promise.
All right. You hear that noise?
Yeah. What is that?
This is those hooligans again. They're over there doing all their cool dance moves. They look pretty cool.
I kind of want to be like them.
I think you're on your way. They're going to... All right, maybe not. Work on it.
Okay.
They're going to get in trouble.
Ooh. Yeah. Where's the supervisor?
Jesus is alive. The empty cross, the empty grave, the life eternal you have won that day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive. Perfect peace, earthly pain finally will cease. Celebrate, Jesus is alive.
This is a construction site! I don't care how cool your dance moves are!
Well, kids, I hope you're having a good day at the construction site. It looks like that house over there is almost done being built. Let's go check it out!
Well, things are shaping up pretty nicely in my house, but they're just so tired and they're sore, and I mean, they've been working so hard, but they made a promise. I really hope they stick to it. That one guy with the cement block, funky pants or something, he's been working hard, but all he ever says is cement block. I don't understand it. I don't know what he's saying, but he's doing a great job. Let's see how it's rolling out. No, that makes no sense. Let's see how things are shaping up.
All right, people. We got day four now. House is almost complete. Just one day left. One more 24-hour period of time. One more 60 times 24 period of minutes.
Cheese and crackers. I'm so sore. I thought it would be stronger than this. Am I swole yet? I don't know if I can do this anymore. I'm not as strong as I thought.
What's the point in this? I say we all head out.
Now hold on there. Hold on. Listen, I get your body is wrecked by every form of physical exhaustion, exertion, and whatnot available to man. And I get you may not see the value in the house you are constructing. But you made an agreement, a promise. And within that promise, you stated that you would build a house.
That reminds me of something.
You can talk?
Just like we promised to build this house, Jesus promised to always love us, and he always keeps his promises, so maybe we should keep ours.
Well, after that oddly insightful moment from the man who we thought could only say the words cement and block, enough of the insights. We get to working, people.
Cement block.
Remember, promises, people. We made them, we fulfill them.
This is the best house!
Admit to God that you're a
guys. Today, we're going to be making your very own magnetic puzzle. Okay, so in your bag, you will find some craft sticks, some magnets, and your Bible verse card. This says, Jesus loves me regardless of my sin. Okay, so the first step you're going to do is you're going to color it. I used markers, but you can also use crayons or colored pencils. Okay, so once you've colored your Bible verse card, you're then going to line up your craft sticks. This is one that we've already made. Now, once they are lined up, you're going to take two pieces of tape, we used blue painter's tape, and you're going to put them on each side, like this. You are then going to take some glue, and we used Elmer's washable school glue, but you can use whatever you have. So you're going to flip it over to the side that does not have your tape on it, and you're going to put a little line of glue on each one. You don't want to put too much, but you also don't want to put too little. Okay, so you're then going to very carefully press your Bible verse card down onto your sticks. The next step is waiting. You're going to have to wait for the glue to dry before you can move on to the next step. So now that your glue is dry, you're going to flip it over and you are going to peel off your tape. Okay, you're then going to take your magnets and you're going to put one magnet in the center of each craft stick. They have a little white peel on the back that you can peel off so you can stick it. And then you're just going to put it in the center of each craft stick like this. Now that our things are dry, you're then going to cut it. Let me show you. And there you go. You have one magnetic craft stick. You will then repeat this step with all of your other craft sticks, and then you have your puzzle. Now you can stick this on your refrigerator or any other magnetic space that you have. Have fun. Bye.
Hey, everybody, welcome back to day 4, and I'm JP.
Hey, everybody, I'm Maddie.
Hey, guys, I'm Noelle.
Today's word is promise.
Today's tool is the cement block.
Yeah, here.
Oh, that was a large noise.
I get that the cement block is a tool, but what does that have to do with life?
Maybe the cement block is hard and life is hard as well.
That kind of makes sense, but let's go ask Miss Kathy to be sure.
Wait, guys, I gotta carry the cement block. Hey, Miss Kathy, tell us about the Bible story today.
Today, our Bible lesson is about Jesus' resurrection and promise, and we're reading from Matthew chapter 28, and we're gonna read a few verses starting in verse 1. So, Matthew 28. Starting in verse 1, you know what? Jesus was arrested, mistreated, and then he was nailed to the cross, all for our sin, because Jesus had no sin. He was perfect and holy, but he chose to go to the cross to shed his blood and give his life for our sin. Jesus didn't stay dead in the tomb. He came back to life. The God we love and serve is living. He is the one true God. So let's start reading in Matthew 28. I'm going to read verses 1 through 10. After the Sabbath, at dawn on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to look at the tomb. There was a violent earthquake, for an angel of the Lord came down from heaven and going to the tomb, rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothes were white as snow. The guards were so afraid of him that they shook and became like dead men. The angel said to the woman, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here. He has risen, just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, he has risen from the dead and is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him. Now I have told you." So the women hurried away from the tomb, afraid yet filled with joy, and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly Jesus met them. "Greetings," he said. They came to him, clasped his feet, and worshiped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." Jesus had been buried, and a large stone rolled over the tomb. And then they even sealed the stone and posted guards because people said, "His disciples may come and steal his body and say he's risen because he said that after he died, he was going to rise again." So they posted guards, they sealed the stone. And so when the women went to the tomb, they thought, "Who's going to roll away the stone?" But the Bible said there was an earthquake, the stone rolled away, and the guards that were guarding the tomb were so afraid they became like dead men. And the angel spoke to the women, and what did he tell them? He said, "Jesus is alive. He's risen just like he told us that he would." And so he said to the women, "Go to Galilee," or "go to the disciples and tell them to go to Galilee, and they'll see me there." So you know what? The women did just what Jesus told them to do. Eventually, they all ended up in Galilee, where they got to see Jesus, and they worshiped him in Galilee. Now, in that same chapter 28, verses 18 through 20, Jesus gives a promise. It says, "Then Jesus came to them and said, 'All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always to the very end of the age.'" You know what? Jesus' promise was that he would always be with us. And he told his disciples to go to all the nations and to all people and tell them the good news of Jesus and that he would always be with them. So you know what our truth for today is? That Jesus will always love me. In your packet, you have some little bricks, just like our big cement block. Things that are in cement are permanent. And so this is to remind you that God's promises are permanent, and they're just as true for us today as they were for the disciples when Jesus was alive. Jesus will always love me. That's our truth for today. And God keeps his promises, doesn't he? So let's pray. Father in heaven, thank you so much that we can trust you to always keep your promises. Thank you that we can serve the one true God and that you love us more than we can imagine. We love you, Father. In Jesus' name, amen.
Where are my tools? Has anybody seen my tools? I can't find them nowheres.
Okay, hi. I'm going to teach you how to do Build My Life on You. I'll build my life on you, on the strength of your love and your mercy and truth. On this rock I stand, not on shifting sand. I'll build my life on you, Jesus. Like that. Now you do it with me. Let's get it.
When I feel afraid, like walls are gonna cave around me, I think about the way your love and grace and peace have found me. Remember what you said, you will never ever leave me. So I'm holding on to all your promises. I build my life on you, on the strength of your love and your mercy and truth. On this rock
that's one of my favorite songs. I'm gonna write about it in my journal. Why don't you guys get your journal out and we'll do journal time.
Okay, in your journals today, it's day 4. So you have a couple activities in your journal, and one of those activities is called skyscraper stories. And if you have some times when you thought maybe Jesus would be mad at you or couldn't forgive you or wouldn't love you for something, you draw those pictures or you can write in the skyscraper. And then you have some stickers in your packet that say, Jesus will always love me. And I want you to take each of those stickers and to stick it over what you drew or what you wrote, because no matter what, Jesus will always love us. So turn off the video, work through your journal, and then when you come back, we'll give you the answers to the bonus verse.
Connie, what are you doing?
You told me to practice.
Hey guys, it's snack time. Okay, so for today's snack, we are going to take ice cream cups or even pudding cups if you have those laying around the house. And these are going to be our concrete mixers. So you're just going to open up your snack. So we just kind of picked some things that we had left over from our snacks from other days, some of our M&Ms, and then just if you have any sprinkles in your cabinet from Easter cookies, Christmas cookies, birthday cupcakes, whatever, we just kind of put a few different little things in the containers for the kids, and then you guys are just going to go in and you're going to add whatever you want to your concrete mixers. So you just get a little pinch. McKenna, do you want to add some stuff into your ice cream?
When you're putting.
So as you can see, it's really easy. Just kind of mix, you know, whatever you have laying around the house. As you can see, the pudding kind of changes colors when you mix stuff in, so it makes it even more fun, right? So guys, just remember today's point is that Jesus will always love me.
Take a bite.
Delicious.
Guys, I was just thinking about this awesome picture my friend Gabby drew. It's awesome. It's like this construction thingy. I mean, I'm not a major guy that knows a lot about construction, but it's a pretty cool picture. I wish I could show it to you. Maybe you saw it in my thought bubble. Can you see thought bubbles? I don't know. I don't know much about nothing, especially construction. I'm out here all day, hammers, saws, nails, ratchets. I'm tired of it. I don't want to do it no more. What I want to do is I want to be a missionary. That would be so awesome, going all over the world telling people about Jesus and whatnot. Oh man, there's a lot of people in the world needs to know about Jesus. I wonder what that would be like to tell them about Jesus and stuff.
Jorge Santiago lives in Comerío, Puerto Rico. And when Hurricane Maria damaged people's homes and lives, Jorge began to see how he can help people.
The town of Comerío is still recovering, and we're facing challenges like sometimes no power and sometimes no water. And we're still working on getting fixed houses.
So Jorge began working with Send Relief, a group made up of volunteer mission teams who meet needs and share Jesus.
We quickly start working with Send Relief, water filter, water and food and stuff, and we quickly move to start bringing those resources to our people in Comerío.
Then Jorge and Sun Relief started helping people fix their homes that were damaged in the hurricane. That's how they met Alfredo and his family.
When Hurricane Maria came, it was a very loud noise. Then roof was destroyed and the water rushed in, and we had to flee until the hurricane passed.
Alfredo and his family had been living without a roof for many months when Jorge and his Sun Relief team showed up to help them. A few months later, Alfredo came to One Church Comerio, a new church that Jorge is starting.
One Church Comerio has done so much for the town of Comerio. Not only has the church given us food, water, and a new roof, but more important, it prays for us.
Now, Alfredo and his family are the first ones at church every morning to pass out water and to hug as people come.
So people start believing. People start believing in what we were doing, and people start believing in the great and awesome God that we all serve.
Jorge always knew that God wanted him to start a new church in Comerio, but he had no idea how quick God would move.
That would be pretty awesome to be a missionary in Puerto Rico, but I'm just here at this construction site. Do you need a passport to go to Puerto Rico? I don't got no passport. I'll never be a missionary because I don't know how to get a passport. I'll probably Google it, but that'd take too long. I need a computer. I don't got a computer. Whatever. I could probably still give to missions, though. I could give an offering to missions. Yeah. You know what? You could give an offering to missions, too. Just put your offering in an envelope or a plastic bag. You could bring it up to First Baptist Church. That'd be a pretty good place to drop off a missions offering, if you ask me. You could bring it to the church office, or you could drop it off on Sunday in one of the big buckets they're probably going to put in the atrium. I bet half that offering would go to help Puerto Rico, and the other half would go to Sam Houston Elementary School. That's a pretty sweet deal. I like that. Ooh. Hey, Connie.
Hey, Construction Jam.
I see you got in your hand a blow pop.
I sure do.
So all I got to say is the motto and the voice, and you give me that blow pop?
That's right.
Oh, it looks so delectable. Let me say that motto.
Okay.
Okay, you got rapa in your mouth. Okay. Is it more flavor?
You gotta risk it to get the lolly.
That's what they say. Okay, the motto is Jesus, our firm foundation.
That's right.
One down, one to go. Then I gets the blow pop. You promise?
I promised.
Okay. I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Philippians 1:6. I got it.
Construction Jam.
Say it. Say it.
It's yours.
It's mine. It's mine. I'm going to go eat this blow pop so quick. I'm going to chew it up. I'm going to eat all them bubble gums all up in there. You guys have a good time. I'm going to go enjoy this blow pop.
Well, kids, that's the end of day 4. We learned a lot today, and we'll learn some more tomorrow. Bye.